going on YouTube? It's your boy Sway back for another YouTube video.
Hold on, I'm trying to fix this thing so I can see. Oh, whatever, I don't even care, to be honest. No, I'm gonna just do it. Fuck it, why not? I'm messing up the lighting. Oh my god. I do it, I can see.
But, what's going on YouTube? It's your boy Sway back for another video. But today, you know, even though I do got some reaction videos coming soon, I wanted to come at y'all. Basically, I don't know why it's so choppy, but whatever. I'm gonna have to figure out what's going on with this and why it's so choppy. But basically, I really making this video so I could let y'all know, like the people who watch me, you know, who want me to post on why I really haven't been posting. So, yeah. Let's cue the intro.
I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point where I love and I hate you, and I cannot change you, so I must replace you.
We're back. So, I kind of know where I'm going to start with this. You know, this is not really the type of content I wanted to make. You know, like, no type of sad stuff, but my life, to be very honest, growing up has been PG-13, like how, like, nothing ever happened in my life. Like, I never really lost nobody, you know, I never done anything, you know, I stayed in the house, played video games, went to play ball, you know, I never really been in any real danger, I never been robbed, stabbed, shot, none of that. You know, I pretty much stayed out the mix. I never got into, like, none of that gang shit, you know, because that's not me. That's never been me. You know, I never really suffered any big losses, like, at all. So, it's like, the first thing, you know, that really happened was obviously this whole corona stuff. You know, everything started changing. Everything started locking up. And my senior year basically got taken from me. Like, no prom, no real graduation, nothing. So, you know, obviously that took a hit mentally, but, you know, I was still on track, you know. But then after that, fast forward maybe, like, you know, a couple months later, I am on a trip with my family, you know, we're having a good time. And then I get news that that my friend had passed away, that I grew up with. And that hit me, like, and it hit me for a lot of different reasons. Like, even when it comes to just, like, me listening to Bobby Shmurda. Because back when I first met him, that's when Bobby Shmurda was hot. And I remember we was outside. I was in middle school at the time. We was outside. And they was playing Hot Nigga. And that's when Hot Nigga was hot. And they was playing it, and I ran up. I didn't even know, like, nobody who's, I didn't know him or nothing. I ran up, hey, and then my boy was like, hey, that's Bobby. And then for the longest time, everybody was calling me Bobby Shmurda because of him, like, everybody. So that was my nickname because of him. When I think of Bobby Shmurda, I think of him. RIP my nigga Butter, like, word. Then after that, you know, that was a big loss, that stuff. You know, I still to this day, I think about it all the time. Like he had moved away, so I haven't really seen him in a minute. So it's like, now I'm never going to get the opportunity to see him again. I'm never going to get the opportunity to dap him up, you know, hoop with him. Because that's all we really did was hoop. Fast forward a couple months later is actually, Before I lost him, when Corona first started, then that's when I also found out that, you know, my parents split. My parents have been together my whole life. Man's just calling me right now. He's ruining my video. I'm going to dub this call real quick. So then I get this news that my parents are splitting. My parents have been together my whole life, you know. So that kind of took a hit on me as well. But, you know, that wasn't really a big hit, you know. It's just something that was on my mind that was kind of stressing me out a little bit. You know, then my dad ends up, you know, moving out. So now it's just me here and my mom. Not to say my dad is, like, out of my life, because I literally go to his crib all the time. But fast forward again, I find out that my friend Anthony had passed away. Another man who I grew up with. I basically met him the same time I met my other friend. Oh, you know, we used to hoop all the time and talk shit to each other. And that shit hurt. Like, I lost him. I lost one. The last person I was talking about, I lost him to a motorcycle accident. And the one I'm talking about now, I lost him to a car crash. Which also had a couple other individuals who I'm pretty sure, like, you know, because Yonkers ain't big. And, you know, that's where I'm from. I probably knew them before. But, you know, I didn't really recognize him. He's calling me again. He's going to ruin my video. You know, that took a hit on me. Losing both of them, it took hits on me. You know, I'm not going to sit here and lie. So, then fast forward more. I find out, my parents have split, right? And I'm on the phone with my dad. And you know how we, like, you be on your phone with your parents or something, and they be around people, they be trying to get you to say hi to everybody. And that's what he did. You know, he scammed me to say hi to some of his friends and all that. Whoa, what's going on here? What's going on here? He was getting me to say hi to some of his friends, and I was saying hi to my godfather. Then he puts me on the phone with his friend. And then his friend is like, "How does it feel to be your older brother?" I'm like, what are you talking about? The only brother I have one blood brother, and I have one god brother. Those are my only brothers. When he said that to me, you know, it didn't really resonate. Until after the call. Because after, like, I was like, what are you talking about? He like, panicked, gave the phone back to my dad. Maybe, like, month or two afterwards, my dad actually, you know, told me himself, like, yeah, you know, I'm going to be an older brother. You know, now, I've never had to take care of a kid in my life. I've only babysat one kid, and that's my stepbrother. Like, that was, like, maybe last month. That was the first time I've ever taken care of a kid or watched a kid. And he's 7, so he's big. I've never held a baby before. I'm scared as fuck to hold babies. All of that. So, this is different to me. Like, it's like everything. It's like as soon as I graduated high school, everything just started hitting me. Like, you know, life just started hitting me. It's crazy. Then, fast forward. This is honestly the biggest hit. Is I find out that my grandmother had cancer. And I think she also had kidney stones or something like that, or blood clots. So now I find out that my grandmother is really sick, and that, you know, she's gonna be going through chemo and all that. And, you know, everything after that seemed like, you know, it was just going good. You know, she was going through chemo, she seemed like she was getting better. And my grandmother, she says to me, she's like, you know, because, you know, she's a very spiritual woman. She says to me, she's like, you know, I can tell everything is working because my hair is growing back. And when you're going through chemo, you know, you lose hair. But when your hair starts growing back, you know, it's really working. And, you know, fast forward some more. You know, she's going through chemo. Everything is good. You know, I go see her all the time, you know. And then she started, like, going through a lot of pain. She's going through a lot of pain because she had fluid that, like, I guess builds up inside her that needs to be, like, drained out. And she had something in her stomach to drain that fluid out. But it was on the opposite side, so she needed to go to the doctor. And then from the doctor, she found out she needed to go to the hospital. When she went to the hospital, that's when they needed to do a procedure on her. And that's what they did. The procedure was a success. Everything was okay. I'm thinking everything's fine, you know. Next day, I'm in the house with my mom. My mom tells me, you know, she's about to go and visit my grandmother in the hospital. Her and my grandfather. They leave. I go to play basketball. I come back home. My mom is not here. I'm wondering where my mom is, because my mom is usually home by the time I get home from playing basketball. I got home at like 9, 10 o'clock. She's normally there. Hours pass by. She's not there. I call her multiple times. I called her a good 5-6 times. She didn't answer any of my calls. I didn't see my mom until the next day. The next morning, I'm getting ready for work. I'm getting ready to leave for work. She comes to the door, and she basically tells me that my grandmother is not doing too hot and that she almost died. And if she's crying, I give her a hug. And then after that, you know, I get to work. And once I got to work, I was like a blank vessel. I was literally a blank vessel. Like, I literally had nothing on my head. I couldn't think. And I couldn't speak. It wasn't until my coworker had, you know, came up to me and was like, bro, like, you all right? You good? I shook my head and just, like, you know, walked away, leaned on something. But, you know, he cares about me, so he wasn't going to just give up. He comes and he puts his hand on my shoulder and he's like, you good? And I just start bawling in tears. I was crying for like an hour straight. You know, just thinking, like, you know, I don't know what I'd do if I lose my grandmother. You know, I don't know how that would hit me, you know, that. You know, I was just letting everything out right then and there. Then, you know, after that, fast forwarding, it was a day I barely got any sleep, probably like 2 hours of sleep. I go to sleep at like maybe 5, 6 o'clock. No, it was 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. I went to sleep. Mom wakes me up at like 6:30, saying, you know, my grandmother's not doing too well in the hospital. Do I want to go see her? In my head, I'm like, if I don't go see her, I'm probably going to regret it if I don't go to the hospital. So that's what we did. Went to the hospital, and, you know, some of my family members were there, a couple of my aunts, and, you know, everybody goes upstairs to see her. In the hospital bed, and I'm trying to build up the strength to go see her in the hospital bed, but I just couldn't. And then out of nowhere, you know, my mom is just like, okay, we're all getting ready to go home. I'm trying to figure out, like, you know, I'm wondering why we're getting ready to go home. And then that's when we get home. You keep in mind, I didn't have nothing but an hour or two of sleep. I come home, you know, I'm trying to, like, do stuff, like, be productive, take my mind off of shit. I'm honestly thinking that everything was okay because we went home so early. So I'm thinking, you know, everything must be okay because we went home early. And I end up falling asleep, and then I wake up to my mom telling me that my grandmother passed away. And I'm not gonna lie, when I first took the information in, it really, like, I wasn't crying, I wasn't sad, I was just relieved. And I was relieved because my grandmother wasn't going through that pain that she was going through when, you know, she was fighting the cancer. You know, she fought the good fight, but she wasn't going through any pain anymore. She was in a lot better place, and she's not in this cruel world anymore. That's what I thought in my head. But it must have, like, stressed me out in some sort of way, because maybe, like, a day or two after, the, you know, a day or two later, I was just laying down. I couldn't really sleep, and all of a sudden, like, a really bad cough, like, I was just coughing really bad, and my neck and my chest felt like somebody was scratching me on the inside. It was just really bad, and it was like that for like a good hour straight. Then the next day, my friends dragged me out the house, because I wanted to leave to go play ball, but at the same time, I didn't. So they basically dragged me out the house to go, and I couldn't hoop. I couldn't. Couldn't lay the ball up, couldn't shoot, I couldn't do anything. I couldn't barely breathe, too. Like, couldn't breathe. It was getting hard to breathe, and we end up losing the game because, you know, I'm trying to like get hot, I'm trying to like get into my groove, and I end up selling, and we lose the game. Then they both start screaming at me, and I don't know what the fuck happened. Like a switch flipped in my head, I went to go sit down. Then I realized, like, I'm like, in my head, I'm like, I gotta get out of here. Like, I have to leave. I'm trying to leave. I can't find the exit to the park. I grab my Bev, and then I start walking, trying to find the exit, until I get to, like, this jungle gym part, and I just collapsed. Caught a panic attack, couldn't breathe, I'm crying. And the only thing, like, I can think, because even now, every single time I close my eyes, I see my grandmother's face. Every single time. And if it wasn't for my two friends being with me, I don't know how I would have got through that situation. But I kind of needed that, need to get that out. Because, you know, you can't really hold stuff like that in. It's going to do a lot more harm than good. So I'm glad I got it out. But, yeah, I don't know if anybody's going to really be seeing this. You know, if you see this, I don't want anybody to feel bad for me. Because, you know, that's not the type of person I am. Like, I'm not doing this video for sympathy. I'm making this video for the people who care. If anybody out there really does care. You know, I'm going to miss my grandmother, but I can't let that hinder me from this, you know, like I did. And it won't happen again. And I promise that it won't happen again. Road to 1K by June is probably done, but we're going to still try. We back on the grind. Hope y'all enjoyed this video. Definitely like, comment, subscribe, turn on post notification bell. See, I never miss an upload from your boy. It's your boy Sway, and I'm out of here.